Hi, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to insert a table anywhere in your document, taking up as much room or as little room as you want, so you can perfectly customize it to suit your needs. So I'm going to go to Insert, Text Box, click on the drop down and select Draw Text Box. Now I'm going to draw this text box anywhere. It doesn't really matter because you can move it around. So I'm going to draw out a text box roughly the size of how I want my table to lie in my document. As you can see here, if I click away, we've got a white background and a black border. So don't worry about that too much at the moment. What we do need to sort out is how the words will fit around this text box. So select it, go to Shape Format, go along to Wrap Text, and for this one, I'll show you how to use Tight here. And this means the words will actually go around that text box as you move it around your document. The next thing you need to do is to insert that table. So click inside the box, make sure your cursor is inside the box. Go to Insert, go to Table, click on the drop down, and you can either use the graph here or the grid here to just select your number of rows and columns, or let's just go back one. Or you can go down to Insert Table and then you can simply put in the number of rows and columns you want to have in your table. Just click OK and as you can see, your table will appear here. Now if you need to adjust your table, if you go down to the bottom right here, just hit your Tab key, then you can just extend the amount of rows you have, or you can select your table by clicking on the top left square, going to Layout, going to Height, and then changing the height of your rows. So let's try 0.6 and press Enter. Let's try 0.8, there we go. And that will extend out to the size of your text box. Now again, if I click away, we've got this ugly border. So if I just click on it, I'm gonna center it, the table actually inside the text box, just to make sure that's perfectly centered. Then I'm going to go to Shape Format, go to Shape Outline and select No Outline. And then we can get rid of that border. And then we can move this anywhere we want. We can line it up with the margin. We can use our arrow keys and perfectly line up our table. Again, if we go to Insert, Text Box, Draw Text Box, and let's draw out a wider one to fit across your page, and we'll use a different wrapping to show you how that will work as well. So again, select your text box, go to Wrap Text, and this time we're going to go to top and bottom. So our text, when we move this table, will only go to the top and the bottom of this text box. Again, put the cursor inside the text box, go to Insert, Table. I'm going to choose three rows, three columns. Again, extend that table out, just one tab. There we go. And then again, make sure the table is centered using Center Text. And let's get rid of that borderline again, no outline. And when you move this around, sometimes it can be a little bit off center. So to ensure that's perfectly in the center of your page, select it, go to Shape Format, Align, click on the drop down, Align to Center, and that table will be perfectly lined up in the middle of your page. You can, of course, have multiple tables. So if I draw a text box, you have multiple tables next to each other. If I customize this text box first by taking out that outline, and then if I just insert the table, let's go to 3x3 and let's just move that up. Let's just sort the text out, Shape Format, Wrap Text, and we'll go top and bottom with this one. If I copy and paste this, let's just make sure that this table's in the center. Let's go to the Home tab, Center. If I copy and paste it, there we go, then I can just line that up together with this one. I can make sure they're in the center and lined up again. So if I select this one, hold down the Command or Control key to select the other one, go to shape format, go to align, and then align them to the center. We'll make sure that they're perfectly lined up across here. If I want them perfectly lined up in the center of my page, I do have to group them first. So select them both, go to group, select group, and then go to align, align to center, and they'll both be perfectly lined up in the center of your page. If you want to edit them, just go to group, ungroup, and then you can obviously go inside and edit your data. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please subscribe and have a great day.